Advanced background check. In this video, we're going to go over options you have at the state and county level to do an advanced background check. To get started, go to sheriffsdepartment.net, and what you'll find available to you is our local resources. And I'm going to go ahead and select the state of Maryland. For this example, you have a very similar process for each of the other states, except for one or two states that make it slightly more difficult. But you should be able to follow along with this example. Your first option is to do a name check. It's an instant search. It looks at records on a national level. It looks at public records, criminal records, some financial things at court level. It looks at some private databases like older address, previous addresses, cell phone records, things like that, some social media things. And it also does some deep web type of searches. It's an instant check. It will show you what it has available almost right away. And then if you proceed to go to the full, if you want the full file, you'll have an option to do that. At the state level, you have your essentials when it comes to background checks, like court records, recorder's office, criminal records, driving records. You can look up a business. You could verify a license. If somebody is a professional license, you could look them up also to make sure everything is legit with the state. Incarceration records, which are prison records, sexual offender registry. At the county level, you're able to look at things like arrests, mugshots, court records, property records, if you want to see what real estate somebody has. So it goes into quite a bit. It's a pretty advanced type of a background check, as you can see, because you can cover so many different aspects of people's life. Anything from real estate documents to court records to criminal records to even business information. So I'm going to go ahead and take a look at a few of these more crucial ones. When it comes to background checks, criminal records are usually sought after, and to do a pretty advanced background check using criminal records. Each state does have an option typically run by the state police or the public safety correctional department. They'll offer some kind of a service, and they'll let you know what it can be used for. Some of them are made for employment purposes. Some of them are made for general purposes, just individual purposes. Know that these background checks are limited to the state. Typically, people do move around. People have previous addresses, maybe in a different state. So you might be missing out if you're just doing a background check in a single state. So either do some kind of variation of a nationwide check, or find out previous addresses and run a background check there if those are that information is available. You also have court records, and in this case it's very simple. It's a statewide database. All you need is a first and a last name. It's a free search. You're able to look at not just criminal records, but you can look at civil records, which could include things like family records, lawsuits, some financial things. You have traffic information, so you're able to get into lots of details, very advanced level stuff. Not every state is going to make it easy like this for you. Sometimes you will have to do these searches at the county level, so they might not have like a statewide database. So just keep that in mind. And different courts will process different records type. As you can see here, you have an opportunity to search both circuit and district courts. In some places, you might not, it might require a little more homework, just a note there. Another couple of things, and these databases are typically free, is you could look up businesses, and you're also able to verify licenses. So if you want to look up a doctor, if you want to look up a realtor, AC installer, contractor, you're able to verify these people through the state. Typically, well, they are free. And then you have inmate, which is a prison record. There is a difference between the county sheriff's jail inmates, and then you have the prison ones. at the Department of Corrections. Anybody that gets sentenced to over 12 months is going to be in the prison system, which every state has a statewide database. And if you want to look at the county level, you're going to have to go to the sheriff's department usually to look up the jail inmates. Every state also will have a sexual offender registry, another important database when it comes to advanced background checks. They're free, and you can use a name to check the database. So these are just some of the things I've gone over. There are various other resources available on sheriffsdepartment.net. I'm going to go ahead and leave a link in the description. You can also just type sheriffsdepartment.net in your browser and come on down and see what we have to offer.